I am an athlete. The concept of pushing my body beyond its limit is my everyday. Not only do I do things that the average person cannot, I make them look effortless. But they are not. Bumps, bruises, tears, and breaks are par for the course. Injury is inevitable, and recovery is manageable. To succeed, I must try again when others would quit, and I must get up when others would stay down. I am not invincible, but to win, I must believe that I am.
But I gotta go to the ghetto to sell these rhymes, right? I mean, these people uptown, they don't break bread when I grip my mic. They don't wanna know about not, they don't give a damn about Mr. Bray. The things I do, what I say, but neither do my people down the way. By the hand of another, I've descended into the sixth level of the abyss. How did I get here?
I don't know.
This isn't why I started this. To live like a thug, to die like a thug too. I'm just trying to get mine to feed my family.
I don't feel sick, but I am. As an individual, and as an athlete, that's very difficult to reconcile. If my bench press numbers or squat numbers go down because of pain, then I can usually trace that pain back to a fall or strain somewhere in training. But this thing that I have is different. When I drop nearly 10% of my body weight going into Copley, the athlete in me wanted to believe that it was because of lack of training and nutrition. But the other part of me, the human part of me, was worried that the cancer had spread.
Welcome to San Antonio International Airport. Baggage claim, carousel 2.
To save money, I decided to take public transportation from the airport to the hotel as opposed to renting a car. It quickly became dark and I quickly became lost.
So what you're gonna do, right, is you're gonna walk down here to Wiener, it's your, the next light, and I think you're gonna make a turn, like you go turn around, so you would turn left and walk that way.
How far of a walk is that?
Oh, it's like maybe like a mile, so you're probably walking for about like maybe, depends how you walk, like 7 to 10 minutes.
Evening. I'm good now. Yes. Reservations for Kenneth Bray.
Monsieur Arisa?
Yeah. What's the closest bus that comes to here?
Closest bus?
Yeah.
Where do you want to go?
To the riverfront, or river walk.
To the river walk? The best way I could suggest is go down the Wiener Road. And there's this 21 coming up, and from there you have to take a 17, which is like an express that takes you directly to the downtown.
Okay, so the 21 goes to Randolph Park and Ride. Okay.
That's room 118.
118. All right. At least I don't have to climb any stairs, right?
sipping, drink in my history. But got twisted, give me a mic so I can spit it.
Hello?
I don't know why I did it, but I did it, now it's too late. I gotta flip it, went in my head straight, but got twisted, give me a mic, so I can spit it. I don't know why I did it.
118 either has somebody in it, or the latch,
so I can spit it.
Who's rockin' rock tonight,
boy?
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 All up in their face like noses. You like how ill the flow is? Rock a long beard like Moses. Since the day I picked up the mic, I'm like smooth and creamy like peanut butter.
What?
Ask your mother, my shit don't stink when I drop it. Splash, make you nod your head like whiplash. Just when you thought you deciphered the rhyme flow, my shit break like a cheap rubber on a tight hoe. Wait a minute, Mr. Postman, what you got?
Oh,
the wrong conclusions arrived at previously. My shit was fat, but they still never heard of me. It couldn't be, cause I keep my fucking game tight. My game is right, plus my fucking game high.
I don't know why I did it, but I did it, now it's too late. I gotta flip it, went in my head straight, but got twisted, give me a mic, so I can spit it.
Shit.
Here at noon. What are you going to need? You're going to need your liability form, your membership. Your membership. Okay?
Great. All right, cool.
That's everything, right?
Yep. Remember, underwear can have no legs, no boxers, no boxer briefs.
I have those on.
I don't need to see them.
I'd gained back all the weight I'd lost going into Copley. Now let's see if I'd gain back the strength. I decided to open my squat at 374 pounds. And even though I was still a little tired from all the walking and my heel was a little sore from the fall 4 days ago, I still felt way better than I did at Copley. In the midst of all the chaos and confusion, I didn't realize that the man lifting directly behind me on the roster was one of the men I was battling for a podium spot, and he was lifting geared. Everyone was lifting geared. Because apparently when I registered for this event, I failed to notice it was an all-equipped meet. Translation, I had accidentally bought a knife to a gunfight.
Platform one, Ken Bray, 264.6 on the bar. Bars loaded for Neymar.
At this point, my only chance of a podium spot and not flying all the way back to Cleveland empty-handed was to start with, hopefully, sticking this last bench press. Wait a minute. I was so distracted by the strengths offered to equip powerlifters in the squat and the bench press, I completely forgot. The gear doesn't offer a significant advantage in the deadlift.
This is the story of how I met Ken Bray at the 2014 Raw Nationals, Aurora, Colorado. We're at the end of the deadlifts. I got my third one whipped. I knew if I got this one whipped, I took second. And that's all I knew. I get all done deadlifting, I look on this over platform, there's some Ken Bray guy, and he's gonna deadlift something, this and that, and crazy thing, and all I can think of myself is, who the fuck is Ken Bray?
You can say what you wanna say, the hustle won't stop, stop, stop. How much of it this can you tolerate? For your ass drop, drop, drop. You keep it real, don't exaggerate, but the shit is still hot, hot. Imitate, okay, okay, but you can never be not, not.
Okay, I'll be out in 5 minutes. So in the end, what did I learn in San Antonio? One, I learned that proper rest and nutrition outweigh saving a buck. Two, I learned that no matter how hopeless things may seem, no matter how impossible the odds, if you change your perspective, even by a little bit, it makes all the difference. Because even if it's dark on the ground, if you fly high enough, you'll see the sunrise.
Making these beats, spitting these rhymes, giving them to the streets, even if they don't deserve it sometimes. Cause no matter what you do, my love is no strings attached. Even if I don't always make it out of it without a scratch, I still gotta watch my back and prepare to squeeze if necessary. But just thinking about that shit is fucking scary.